Graphic Audio. A movie in your mind.
Graphic Audio presents Stage Station by Ernest Haycox.
It is ready.
Rosalia Durez gave the table one last glance to make sure that the owner, who believed it a sin to be ungenerous, could find no fault with the meal. The arrival of Tobe Urquhart, driving the Tonto stage, shattered the hot drowse lying all about Folliard Station.
15 minutes to eat. Do what you gotta do.
Oh, my. I've become a bit lightheaded.
Well, let me help you, Mrs. King.
The light of the desert was a white-hot blast, and when the woman stepped into the thick shadows of this adobe-walled room, she put out her hands as though blinded. The other passengers crowded around her, and her shoulders tipped a little, and then the owner stepped into the room, and the woman caught the front of his shirt with her fingers.
Oh, it has made me a little faint.
From the corner of the room, Rosalia Durez observed this with a practical and dissenting interest. The woman was surrounded by men, but it was the owner on whom she placed her hands, and the owner looked at her and was pleased. There was, Rosalia thought, nothing wrong with the woman's eyes. Tobe jerked his thumb.
Miss King, this is Tom Folliard, who runs the station. It's one of the few stations in Arizona the Apaches ain't had any luck with.
There you go.
The owner helped Mrs. King to the table and took his own place. Everybody, made impatient by time and hunger, fell upon the meal. Rosalia stepped forward, her round and white and firm arms grazing the owner's shoulders as she poured his coffee. It was against his wishes to be served first, but Rosalia, obedient in most things, had her own gently stubborn convictions. This was the owner's house, and this was his table. Afterward, she moved to Mrs. King. There was a perfume in Mrs. King's chestnut hair and firmness to her skin. The day's heat had deepened her complexion. Small, faint freckles showed around the base of her nose. Rosalia Durez's appearance instantly drew Mrs. King's quick and close regard, and there was at the moment no smiling in her eyes. They were cool and made heavy by a dark old wisdom, and they turned from Rosalia to the owner and back to Rosalia again, until Rosalia knew what the Senora was thinking.
If only it were true.
She circled the table with her own eyes discreetly lowered and went into the kitchen. Her mother moved from the hot stove.
I hear a woman out there. There is danger in the desert for a woman.
She would not be afraid.
Rosalia moved back to the dining room. She stood in a corner, listening. Tobe Urquhart took a breath from eating and turned to the owner.
Should be a cavalry guard waiting at the top of the pass. Any Apache sign around here?
Not much.
Any sign is too much. All right, folks.
They rose at his word. Tobe Urquhart was a tall man, but the owner was taller. The owner had heavy shoulders and heavy legs, and he had a voice that made men turn. All the sun in Arizona couldn't darken his skin, and his lips were long and made for smiling, but they were firm at the corners, and his eyes were gray. Rosalia saw how strong was the Senora's interest as she watched the owner. The Senora was fair and pretty. She put a palm gracefully toward her head.
Oh, I had not counted on this heat. It will be much worse this afternoon. If you don't mind, I'll stay over into the next stage, Mr. Folliard.
Her appetite was not ill.
Certainly.
The owner, Thomas, seemed pleased and followed the other passengers into the glass-glittering light.
We'll keep an eye out for marauders. I'll be happy to get to the pass with the cavalry. So long. Yeah!
The stage's wheels groaned into motion, and for a little while the run of the horses was a descending beat in the day. Then the solid, sultry quiet returned to Folliard Station, and the owner came in with Senora King's flower-patterned portmanteau.
Rosalia, which room will Mrs. King use? Mrs. King, this is Rosalia Durez.
Rosalia lowered her eyes.
How are you, Rosalia?
Tom Folliard looked at Senora King.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.